Welcome to MSD Learning World. Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to see another sorting that is done by using divide and conquer. The sorting is a quick sort. You know this is an effective sorting method. The difference between the merge sort and the quick sort is that in the merge sort application, the major process of checking or sorting is done only at the combine and the conquer step. While you are dividing the elements into subarrays, the only task that it will be doing is finding the mid element index. So it is nothing but the total number of elements divided by 2. So no operation is done in the divide step. Whereas in this quick sort, while the major operation or the sorting of the elements or everything is completed in the divide step itself. So here the quick sort will be more effective than the merge sort. Here the element is not going to be divided, or the entire array is not going to be divided based on the mid element. It is going to be divided based on the pivot element that we choose in the array. So here in the quick sort, there are three parts that is performed in the quick sort algorithm. That is, in the first step of divide, the entire array element is going to be divided into 2 by taking the pivot element in the set of all elements in the array. So in general, you can select the pivot element either as the first element from the n array elements or at the last element. But generally, we always do the quick sort by selecting the last element as the pivot element. By keeping the last element as the pivot element, we try to compare the pivot element from the first element to till the last element of the array. And then in this divide step, the pivot element is compared with each and every element starting from the left hand side to the right hand side of the n number of elements to check and to divide the array in such a way that the pivot element is fixed at one point, but the pivot element where it is fixed is not the exact position where it is can be in the half of the elements of the n number of elements. For example, when you have 10 number of elements, the pivot element is not going to be always in the fifth position, because as the pivot element varies, we cannot tell where the pivot element can be kept. But we have to see to that the quicksort algorithm will make all the elements that is placed before the pivot element on the left hand side will be lesser than the pivot element, and all the elements that are kept after the pivot element on the right hand side of the array will be the largest element than the pivot. So this is what is done in the divide step. Then coming to conquer, while it is performing conquer operation, again the left and right subarray is again taken into account, and the last element of the left subarray is again taken as a pivot, and it is the left subarray is divided, and the right subarray is again divided by taking the last element as the pivot, and it is subdivided into 2 parts. Likewise, recursively in the conquer step, the entire array elements is going to be divided based on the pivot element. So at last, after it is performing the conquer, the pivot element is placed in such a way that the left hand side elements will be lesser than the pivot and the right hand side elements will be larger than the pivot. Let us see an example for the quicksort algorithm. So here, instead of seeing the steps, let us see an example problem so that you understand the steps for the quicksort algorithm very easily. So now let us take the numbers as 8761092. So here we are going to take the last number 2 as the pivot element, and we are going to have a pivot pointer as the first pointer, and the second pointer of this problem is going to be the first element, which is the second pointer as number 8. So coming to the first iteration, what the first step that it is going to do is, while it is now the first task is to keep the pivot element in a position where the numbers to left to it are the lesser than the pivot, and the number right to the pivot must be the larger than the pivot element. For that, while you are placing the element itself, you have to compare it and you have to keep the elements accordingly. So now in the first iteration, in the first step, what it is going to do is, it is checking pivot element 2 is greater than 7. So it is no. Once it is no, it is just checking with the next element. So in the second step, it is checking again 2 is greater than 7, it is no. So moving to the third step, and it is checking 2 is greater than 6, it is no. So in the next step, it is checking with the 2 is greater than 1, it is yes. So it is trying to check an element which is lesser than the pivot element. So when it is seeing an element 1 which is lesser than 2, it try to swap the element 1 with the element present in the second pointer. So the second pointer is pointing to the number 8. So it swaps 1 and 8 and it tries to move the second pointer to the next element. So now the elements become 1, 7, 6, 8 and then 0, 9, 2 and now the second pointer is moved to 7. In the next step, it is going to check whether 2 is greater than 0. It is yes. So now, since 0 is lesser than the pivot, now 0 and the element present in the second pointer, 7 is swapped, and then the second pointer is moved to the next element, 6. So 0 and 7 is swapped, and now the elements will be 1, 0, 6, 8, 7, 9, and 2. And the second pointer is now pointing to 6. Now it is checking 2 is greater than 9. So it is no, the condition is not satisfied. So now what it is checking is, it is moving to check for the next element, but there is no next element. When there is a no next element, it is clearly seen that all the elements and the swapping is done, and now it is going to search for the element where the second pointer is present. So the element where the second pointer is present is the highest element than the pivot element, and after the second pointer, the elements are going to be greater than the pivot. So it is going to just swap the element 2 with the element present in the second pointer 6. So 2 is swapped, and after the first iteration you have 1 0 2 8 7 9 6, and 2 is placed in the third position where 1 and 0 is less than 2 and 8 7 9 6 are greater than 2. This is what is the first iteration. So now after the first iteration, the elements are going to be 1 0 2 8 7 9 6, and where 2 is the pivot element. Now for the left subarray and the right subarray, again the divide process is going to happen. So now let us take the left subarray alone, which is 1 0, where 1 is taken as the second pointer and 2 0 is taken as the pivot element. So now pivot element is checked with 1, and so 0 0 is less than 1. So the element 0 has to, and second pointer is present, and there is no element after the second pointer, so that 0 and 1 gets swapped. Now 0 and 1 and 2. So this is complete. Left subarray is in sorted order. Now coming to the right subarray, you have 8, 7, 9 and 6. So in that, 6 is going to be pivot and 8 is going to be the second pointer. Now in the first step, what it is going to do is, whether 6 greater than 8, no. So it is checking with the, in the next step, it is checking with the next element. 6 greater than 7, no. And it is checking with the next element. 6 greater than 9, no. So now it is in the next step, what it is going to do is, the number 6 is checking for some element which is present after 9, but there is no other element after 9. So what it assumes that there is no elements to check, and all the element that it has checked now is all greater than the pivot element. So now it go and searches for the second pointer. So this pointer, second pointer is 8, and after second pointer all the elements are checked and they are greater than the pivot element. So it is going to swap the pivot element with the second pointer value. So 6 and 8 is swapped, and after the second iteration the elements are going to be 0 1 2 6 7 9 8. So here that you can notice that when the element 6 is placed, there are no other elements present on the left subarray. So the left subarray is completely empty. So the pivot element decides whether there is going to be any left subarray or not. So whenever the pivot element that you are choosing is a minimum value, then you will not have left subarray at all. Now after the second iteration, the numbers are going to be 0, 1, 2, 6, 7, 9 and 8, where 2 is already a pivot element which is already placed, and 6 is a pivot element where there is no left subarray. So again the divide process is going to happen in the third iteration for the right subarray of the second subarray. So here the right subarray contains the element like 7, 9 and 8, where second pointer is 7 and the 8 is taken as a pivot element. So now 8 greater than 7, condition is yes. and so that we are going to if the condition is yes and you are not going to swap it, you are, and the lesser number contains the second pointer, then what you will do is the second pointer will alone be just moved. If the element present in the second pointer is different and the element that you are searching is different, then you will swap it. If the element that you are searching itself is lesser than the pivot element, then the second pointer alone it's getting moved to the next element. So now you move the second pointer alone to the next element. So second pointer is moved to 9. Now 8 is checked with 9. 8 greater than 9, condition is no. And in the next step, 8 is going to be compared with the next element, but there is no next element after 9. So since there is no next element, the array is going to search for the element where the second pointer is there. The second pointer is present only in 9. So the 9 and 8 get swapped in such a way that compulsorily the elements that is going to be placed before pivot is smaller and the element placed after pivot is larger. So see, when you are making the divide operation itself, the elements are 0, 1, 2, 6, 7, 8 and 9, but all these elements are kept individually in the arrays, subarrays. Now what we will do in the combined step is that all the arrays are just added without making any comparison. So in this quick sort, the conquer and the combined step is going to be doing a minimal operation, and it is considerably, there is no calculations in your combined step in the quick sort algorithm. Combine is going to combine the elements as such by its index without making any comparison. I think you understood the quick sort algorithm by making how the sorting is actually done in each and every steps. Let us see the quick sort algorithm here. So quick sort, the algorithm is going to have the input value as array, the leftmost index and the rightmost index. The leftmost index is nothing but the second pointer and the rightmost index is nothing but the pivot element. So the left is less than the rightmost index, you start making the pivot index and you are going to again make the partition and you are going to call the quick sort again for the left subarray and right subarray continuously and recursively. So this is what you are going to perform in the quick sort. Coming to the partition, partition is to make the element to pivot to be placed in the exact position. So it is also getting the elements as array, leftmost index and rightmost index. So first you are keeping the rightmost index as the pivot index, the pivot index that you are taking as the last element. Then you are storing the index as leftmost index minus 1. It is already 1, so 1 minus 1 is 0. So initially your first element is going to be the leftmost index. So for each and every loop, for first you are going to check pivot element with the first element. If the condition is no, then you are going to just increment the pointer. So for all the elements that is present before the pivot element, n number of iteration is going to be done for placing the pivot element in the exact position. So for loop starts here, for I equal to leftmost index to rightmost index, it is going to check the element present in the leftmost index with the pivot element. So the element of I is the element present in the leftmost index, pivot element is the element present in the rightmost index. So element is less than the pivot element, now you need to swap it. If the element is greater than the pivot, you have to leave and move the second pointer alone. So like that, this is going to happen for all the I values from the leftmost index to the rightmost index, and this happens until the pivot element is kept in the exact position. So when we see the time complexity of the quick sort algorithm, when we consider the case like worst case complexity, the worst case complexity in that, in the sense that the worst case complexity does not depends upon the number of elements present in the array or whether the elements are sorted or not sorted, that doesn't deals with the worst case complexity when we deal with the quick sort algorithm. Other sense, whenever the pivot element that we choose is the least value of all the elements or the highest value of all the elements, then the pivot element will be placed either on the left end of the array and right end of the array. So at each iteration we are going to have either there will be no element in the left subarray when we have the pivot element is the largest element, and we will not have right subarray when the element that we are taking is the least element. So the array will not be existed for further division of the subarrays, and each and every time whenever we are making the dividing process, we are going to process all the n minus 1 elements. So for outer iteration of n number of elements, and for inner iteration of division also we are going to perform for n number of times. So n into n, it is going to be order of n square. And now coming to the best case complexity, the division is going to happen only for n by 2 number of times, whereas the comparison is going to taken for n number of times. So for the best case and average case, the time complexity is going to be order of n log n. And coming to the space complexity also, the quicksort algorithm is going to have half of the storage of n by 2 iterations, so it is going to be order of log n. So here in this video we have seen quicksort algorithm and how it is performing by using a divide and conquer approach, and we have seen an example problem, and we have seen each and every step how the quicksort algorithm is solved and how the elements are partitioned and how are we getting the sorted array. And we have seen the algorithm for quicksorting, and the worst case complexity of the quicksort is order of n square, whereas best case and the average case complexity of the quicksort algorithm is order of log n. And we have seen the space complexity of order of log n. So do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe the channel. Thank you. Bye.